boys and girls. Sorry I haven't been around for much lately. I've just torn a gut over his bloody cough. It's been a bit of a nightmare, so forgive me if I just start coughing through. I might have to edit it out, it's been a nightmare. Bronchitis, some sort of shit going around. Anyway, enough of all that, it's irrelevant really. This video is going to be like an update video really, about things that's going to be happening to me and my channel pretty soon. Quite a few shout outs, some unboxings that have been missed because, you know, I've been under the weather and the last thing I want to do is to do unboxings, cough me bloody guts up all the time. So I've got some thank yous and some shout outs to mention, and also another unboxing. I've been looking forward to receiving this, blimey, for about 3 weeks now, and it couldn't have come at a better time. Seriously, you won't believe how urgent I need this. So without further ado, let's get open and see what's in it. It's got like a pull here tab, oh, which actually works, which is nice. Plan B. I wasn't going to mention this until later on, but I might as well do it now. I just acquired one of these, a Falkner in A1. Check this. That is a proper blade, brother. Look how thick it is. How cool is that? From a really good chum on YouTube. Luke. Oh, mate. I've got to get you back for this because I what, paid you. It just wasn't enough. So look out for some payback, mate. I don't know when, but this year, definitely. And that edge is, oh, ridiculous. It's a sweet blade. The sheath looks a bit weird, but doesn't matter because it functions perfectly. And I like the idea of the old Ranger bands and the ferro rod on there as well. Outdoor Survivalist 101. Look out for his new channel. Sorry, Luke. Right, anyway. Oh, my God. You're going to love this, you guys. All you knife nuts. Get all the bullshit out of here. Right. Right, let's get the formalities out of the way. I had to pay £21 charge, customs. Because this is the way it is, because the value that's been put on the customs declaration dispatch note, just over $50, which is, it's bullshit really, because the contents, sorry, the value of these two knives is around $500. So as much as they tried to get me, you know, off the hook as it were, I still got stung by bloody customs. Friggin' UK, I'll tell you what, it's turned into a bloody Fort Knox. I mean, look at this. That's true. They're stealing our money. They're stealing our money. So, don't know why I bothered putting this away. We're going to need this to get into this. Now, I've got a small knife and a big knife. I'm really interested in the big knife, really. So, let's put that away for now. By Topps Knives. Look at the size of that. How cool. That's a knife. Holy shit. I've got to take the little wrapper off the handle. Be very, very careful. Oh, wow. Gee whiz. That is proper sharp sawback as well. Rock solid, drop point. Yeah, that's plenty sharp as well. Yeah, let's have a close up.
I can get it all in the shot. The handles on that baby. Beautiful handles. Really nice. I'm not sure if that's picking it up. So yeah. A really nice tool.
That's gonna be my survival tool, I think. If you wanted a knife to survive, I mean, you're going to be battening on the ends, because I don't know if you, all of you know, but when you're battening, batten on the end of the blade, not in the middle or this end, because if you batten from say there to there, it's just going to cause vibrations into your hand and it's going to be uncomfortable, blisters, hot spots revealed in the handle, blah blah, always batten on the end. So that's why that bit's nice and flat. And obviously that's going to be used for sawing. You can tool right up there. Oh, look at that. It's a beast, isn't it? So, it's a fantastic sheath as well. Really looks the business. So let's put that down. I won't get too excited. And they've thrown this little baby in as well. This is brand new actually. It's only been out a couple of weeks. So again, it might even be one of the first in the UK to get one of these. Tops knives, look at that, you get a little survival emergency whistle. Quality. Again, great little sheaves as well. Look at that, Molly compatible, D-Link carry, quick release, ballistic nylon sheath. Let's get this little baby out. Oh, there's a chunk. Wow, look at this for a folder. How funky is that? It's the XCEST Delta. And now it's got a proper bloody lock on there as well. It's a liner lock. And yeah, you can open it one-handed, which is cool. Getting another close-up. Apologise if it's not coming in focus. Let me see if I can move that around. That's better. Yeah, we're focusing good. Nice, thick, chunky handle. Really nice. And the blade, man. Wow. What a nice shape. Bloody expensive these are. I'm so lucky to have acquired one. It's a good size. Fits really good in the hand, actually. And if you guys don't know about it already, right in the middle there, it's like a recess in the middle. That's for doing your bow drill. Right in the middle. And actually, in fact, if your little middle finger fits nicely in that hole to get a good grip. Nice jimping as well. Nice little tool, mate, nice little tool. Yeah, really impressed with the knives. Can't believe they finally made it all the way here from Idaho. So let's put them away. So the fork clipping from courtesy of Luke. Outdoor Enthusiast 101. I've got to say his name again because I love the guy. He does some brilliant videos and severely underrated. He needs some more subs. He really does. He's a great guy. His honesty really shines through in his videos. So we love Luke. It's a shame he can't make it to the Bushcraft Show, Luke, because a lot of guys want to meet up with you, mate. I think you've got quite a following there, mate. You've got a lot of good fans and subs. We'd love to meet you, but like most things, you know, one day it's going to happen. Going on to another knife, this is Blade Central, isn't it? It's owned by Jackraw knife, but got another Jackraw, got two now. If I can get it out, it's nice and tough. I just love the handles on it. Check it out. Really nice.
Sandy's done an amazing job. Just love the colour. It's beautiful, isn't it? And it's got a new like profile design. I don't know if it's showing up on the handles there, where it swells quite a bit in the middle. Mosaic pins, extra wide lanyard hole, which is one of the reasons why this knife is in my hand. But that's a long story. Of course, you've got the Jackraw logo on there. And from what I've been hearing from Sandy, I was supposed to on the phone the other night. Yeah, that's sticky sharp. That's just gonna. That's totally insane. The it's actually changed the grind angle on the Scandi bevel there. I think it was 22, now to 15. So it's going to take less time to sharpen. And obviously, when you're battening, the angle is more of an abrupt V, which is going to split and separate the material a lot more efficiently than a thinner edge. Also, the edge is going to be a lot stronger because it's not as thin at the end. So, around 59 Rockwell, which is brilliant. It's just about perfect.
It really is. So, a nice one, Sandy. Can't thank you enough, mate. As a sort of thank you, I've just got him a ticket to the Bushcraft Show. So, Sandy from Jackraw Knives will be at the Bushcraft Show 2013. Got him a 3-day pass. So, yeah, looking forward to meeting up with you, mate. It's been too long. Right, trying to whiz through all this. Shout outs and some mentions to some people. Quality Jackson. I can't thank this guy highly enough. He's a great supporter of my channel and he's such a generous guy, shipping gifts to people. He doesn't really demand unboxing videos. In actual fact, he just sort of says, don't bother, don't worry. Which is amazing. He sent me quite a few bits and pieces and, you know, he just said, don't do a video, don't worry about it. So, yeah. What can I say? Tom, you're a legend, mate. And for all those who don't know Quality Jackson, Tom, he's just done a recent series of videos. I think he's done about 4 or 5 on Shit It's the Fan scenario in the UK, based in Bristol, which is near where he lives. Really cool, really good, and I thoroughly recommend you guys to watch these videos. I think they're about 15 minutes, give or take, each, and there's 4 of them. And it's a scenario about like dirty bombs going off, and it's really well done. So credit to you, Tom. You've done a really good job on that, mate. And I'm going to put a link to them videos underneath this video. So if you've got time, you know, you put the TV on and it's sort of crap, which usually is like constipation street and all that bullshit. Watch some of Tom's videos. They're really, really entertaining. Love them to death. Moving on, James Hunter, formerly Hunterian 1986. I think he fell to the that trap that YouTube set up where you got to put your real name in. You know, it's complete bullshit. But obviously, James has decided to do that. Recently sent me some Hexi blocks and a little Hexi stove as well. It's different from the issue ones that I had when I was in. I mean, this one's got a cutout, which the BCB Crusader mug fits in. So it's going to be really efficient, you know, keeping the wind off and getting it to pour as quick as possible. So, you know, I asked them, James, if he can get hold of Hexi Box 3, because I think he's got a brother-in-law in the army or something. I think he's still serving now on ops, probably Afghan, I expect. If he can get them for free, then brilliant, and I'll pay for the postage. So the little bugger sent, I don't know, 5 or 6 of them. And he said, don't worry about the postage. So, yeah, I'm going to get you back, James. I will, mate. Along with, like, about 300 other people, but I will get you back. My good friend over in the US, Howler942, another James. Man, he just sent me a box about half the size of the this one. And it had stuff in it, which I just couldn't believe. He said, oh, don't worry about it, you know, it arrived at work and I emailed him. And he goes, oh, open it now, mate, you know, don't worry about an unboxing video. When I opened it, bloody had silver coins in there, whiskey in there, cigars in there, cigar holders, it had bloody, what else did it have in there? And a wool for my wife, because she's into crocheting. So all that stuff, like, a hip flask in there. And it's just ridiculous. And I really wish I filmed it now, because the generosity of this guy is brilliant. He hasn't put any videos up himself. He's just a big supporter of me and Wessex Blades, our channels. So I can't thank you enough, mate. Hasn't gone unnoted. Really, really appreciate that. It's an amazing gift. And I'm a cockroach, my good buddy. We're going to be filming pretty soon for the next episode of UK Preppers. So looking forward to having you down, Mike, in my manor again. It's not too far from where I am. So it's going to be a great laugh. I'm really looking forward to that. And, you know, recently I've done an overnight with Roach, which not many of you know about. It wasn't filmed. In actual fact, it was around his house. It wasn't in the woods because, you know, he's got some kids in the house. Can't leave them, so why not? So had a great time. And Mike's going to be doing an interesting video pretty soon, within the next 2 months, I would say, somewhere in that time frame. And YouTube, I don't think it's going to be ready for his video. Man, it's going to blow your socks off. All I can say that it's going to be a project that I'll give him a helping hand, getting hold of it, should we say, and getting it back to his place. And that's all I can say. The rest of it's a surprise, but it's going to be an amazing video. Never been seen on YouTube, as far as I'm aware. It's unique. And, mate, I can't wait to look to see his video too. It's going to be brilliant. Also, lastly but not least, Patrick, Terra Firma. Terra Firma Films is a new guy. I think he's been spending a lot of time studying most of us on YouTube, just to learn really, because YouTube is a fantastic pool of knowledge, and I think he's well and truly dipped his feet in there, loved it, and now he's gone head first, he's right under the water. He's started to do his own videos, some overnighters and stuff, which is really, really great. I mean, the things you said about myself really blew me away, Patrick, to be honest. Seriously did. It blew me away, mate. Such a nice guy. And grew up on the east coast of Scotland. It's a hell of a long way from near Portsmouth, right down on the south coast of England. But one day, it'd be nice to meet up, mate. It really would. You know, a couple of nights overnight, have big campfires, talk shit, fishing, a few beers. How cool is that? So, yeah, get yourself off to Patrick's channel, Terra Firma. I'll put all the links to all of his shout-outs underneath. Basically, he's going to spend a year, give or take, going around Scotland doing a film, a proper short film. So, all the best, mate, really. And you've done a really cool time-lapse thing on your latest one. So, I've only done a few practice ones from, you know, the house out the window. And that one I've done on the Silbury Wild Camp on the 21st of December. Oh, excuse me. But to be honest, that was a bit of a disaster because it was so cold, the lens fogged up, and of course it's taking a shot every 5 seconds. And there's no way you can physically just wipe the lens off. You're going to risk moving the camera around. So it come out a bit naff. So, you know, as the weather gets better in the UK, it's not as cold and the lenses don't steam up. Yeah, I'm going to be doing some time-lapse stuff because I love it. So, sod it. I'll just chuck one on there now. I practiced when I done it a little while ago. Check this. So yeah, I'm glad you like the old the time-lapse thing. It's pretty easy. Just set your tripod up where it ain't going to be moved. No one's going to be walking in front of it and just stick it on time-lapse. You can do it from 1 second. Every 1 second it takes a photograph and you just post them all together and just speeds it up. 1 second, 5 second, 10 second, 30, whatever. You can wear this, make it up. So yeah, it's really cool, really effective, and a bit of music over it as well. It is nice. So yeah. Big fan of time-lapses, Patrick. Nice one, mate. Looking forward to your film as well. It's going to be cool. Basically, it. I think in over the next 10 days or so, I'm going to be being filmed by Bullseye TV, which are selling the program to National Geographic. UK Preppers, I think episode 2, we can call it for now, really. They wanted me to do some publicity stuff to front it. And I declined it, to be honest, because I just haven't got the time. You know, having a full-time job, a YouTube hobby, prepping as well, you know, I've got a wife and a family. It's just no chance I can be running around doing interviews and BBC and newspapers. I ain't got the time. So I handed the baton over to Mike, I'm a cockroach, and he's going to run with it. Great. Oh, good luck to you, mate. So do a good job fronting the programme. I'm sure it's going to be stonking. I think Bullseye learned a hell of a lot on the last episode they'd done. So this one is going to run pretty cool. So look out for that. I think it's due to hit the UK screens June, July, August. Any time around there. I mean, you know, Bullseye TV's got to edit it about 2 or 3 times. And then it goes to National Geographic. They're going to edit it again. It's going to be launched in the UK, Europe, and then worldwide. And of course, it's going to be repeated on Dave and all the rest of it, like everything else. So yeah, it's going to be a bit weird, you know, seeing yourself on telly. You know, initial fears were, you know, they're going to make me look a bloody lunatic. But then after really seriously giving it some thought, they can only make me a lunatic if I give them the opportunity to. You know, if I trip over a tent peg, or if I drop something, or if I fall on my arse. You know, chances are they're going to stick it on there, and, you know, I'm fair game. So all I've got to do is don't cock up. Yeah, right. Easier said than done, isn't it? What can you do? So I'm just going to go there, be myself, you know, just exactly how I am in front of camera on YouTube. Well, nothing to lose. Tom, actually, from Our Man, said to me, are you nervous? I said, no, not really, to be honest. I'm just going to stand in front of the camera like I'm doing now, prat around, have a laugh, do what I do. But the only thing that's concerning me is all my kit and stuff getting wet, because it's going to be forecast heavy rain. It's going to be swamping in mud. And I haven't really got the space to dry it all off and clean it all at the moment, because the weather in the UK has been really shit, to be honest. It's been rain. If it ain't rain, it's snow or ice, freezing cold, bloody Arctic winds. So yeah, having a night out in a bloody muddy, pissing down woods, freezing cold, sounds like a right laugh, doesn't it? Anyway, I'm blabbering on, so that's basically the update, the Preppers UK thing's coming up really soon, within the next 10 days or so. So I'm going to be in that. Armored Cockroach is going to be doing a little cameo in there as well, where both of us are going to be doing some YouTube stuff in there to promote the YouTube community. So hopefully when people see the documentary, they're going to be wanting to see the YouTube stuff as well. So fantastic, really made up. So that's pretty much it, guys. I thought I'd do an update. As I say, I've been off air for a while because this bloody cough has just been going on and on and on. It's starting to get a bit better now, so I thought, right, I'll get this done, get it out of the way. After filming this and uploading this, what will be Friday, the 15th of March, I'm going to be pretty much focused on gearing up for this TV thing, really. You know, going through my preps, making sure everything's in order. I mean, it's like a one-day window. And I don't really want to leave it all to the last minute and run around with my head hanging out my ass. I want to get it prepped because preppers have to, right? I can't win, can I? So I have to do that. So that's it now. You're not going to be seeing me on YouTube for the next couple of weeks or so. So thanks for all your support, guys. It really means a lot. And if I've missed anyone out on this brief shout out, I really am sorry. But, you know, time's against us. And, you know, to be honest, if I was to thank everyone, I'd be here for bloody hours. So thanks for watching, guys. I'm going to be playing my new toy now, and I'm going to try my best not to cut myself. So thanks a lot, guys, and stay funky.
Hope I get the chance to say goodbye.